congratulate you on this compilation. It's a really great body of work, and I think coming from you, it has extra significance.
Thank you very much. It's very nice to meet someone who knows about the subject.
Well, thanks. I've been devoted to it for a long time.
Yes, I'm very pleased to say that this is Edward Seaga, here with the host of Reggae Boomshot. I'm just looking at some selections I made from the selection.
So you are the selector.
Oh, yeah.
We've been working on this top 10.
Oh.
And we've reached top 20 now.
Oh, you only cut down to 20.
Yeah.
Well, you got
10.
This is the 25. Okay.
Can't even really.
But he really has a top 25.
You know, I was most intrigued by one selection out of all of the records that you picked for this. There was one song that I had never heard before. Ram Goat Liver.
Ram Goat Liver, good for me. Mannish water, really good. Eat me the herring for your daughter. For a good lunch, put the bite in your back. It make your daughter.
Pluto Shervington, yes.
I know that, but there are about three or four different types of records like that. The Stand in a Class by themselves, Ram Goat Liver, Carrie Go Bring Home,
Jacqueline No Mysteries.
Yes, that sort of thing. You can't put them in any class. They're just real old-time Jamaican stuff.
Now, I have never heard of the song before. Was this a very popular song, or was this a rare?
Very popular.
Really?
And what was the other one that was said to be the first reggae?
Rambo Liver, that's the Pluto Sherrington.
Yes, yes.
Not Rambo Liver, there's another one like that.
Ernest Smith?
No.
Was it Easy Snapping?
The One Shot. They just made that record and that was it. They never came back.
Baba boy. Is that a delicacy to eat the liver of the ram goat? Like in a, you know, when you're currying the goat?
It's part of the mannish water. Tell them what mannish water is.
Well, the goat is a popular meat.
Yes.
Not as a goat mutton for purposes of chops or roast or anything like that, but for making curry.
Okay.
So the curry mutton, but this case it's a goat that replaces the sheep.
Okay.
And well, since the goat
so it's for religious purposes too.
Since the goat is dead, they use all other parts possible and put it into a big soup, which they call mannish water.
Mannish water, okay.
You say certain parts of it.
What did you do with my kid, man?
Have you tried the mannish water before?
Oh, it's popular, yeah.
Is it good?
It's supposed to be mannish water.
It's supposed to give you the strength.
Oh, it's another one of those.
It's another one called Strong
Back. Which one?
Called Strong Back. It make you da-da.
Again, this is a great pleasure to be speaking with you about one of my favorite subjects, which is Jamaican music. And I understand that it's been a big part of your life, even before you were involved in public life, that music was really a passion of yours.
That's right.
I'm aware that you did a lot of research on folk music and the rituals, the polka mania, and things of that nature.
You're up to date.
Well, I've read your memoirs.
Really?
Yes, both volumes. I have one of them in my bag with me now.
Really good.
They were written to be read, I assume. So, but I wonder if you could just tell me, based on your research in folk music, what is the function of music in Jamaican culture? Because it's not, it seems to me it's more than just entertainment, that there's a use that music serves, like a purpose for music in Jamaica.
at the folk music level, there is a category that is called ring games. This is games that children play. And usually it's in a ring, that they form a ring and so on. And there's a host of songs that are used for them. But that's, doesn't mean they can't be used otherwise.
Mm-hmm.
But that's the ring game songs. Then you have songs that you use for, and Babsy mentioned the sit-ups, and you just sit up all night after a person is dead.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What you call a week.
Yes.
You have songs that are used for work, especially when you're digging holes to plant yams.
Mm.
And you're digging it with a pickaxe. You know, pickaxe has a sharp edge, an arc and a sharp edge both ways. And you have to swing it down into a hole that you're digging, and it's not you alone but a group of you.
Yes.
And it comes out and it makes a sound as it hits the ground, it's a rhythm. And those are called digging songs.
Okay.
So there's a group of songs that are there for just about every area of life.
So there are different uses for music. It's not just entertainment. Music serves a purpose, doesn't it?
That's right.
And even into modern music, what do you feel is the purpose of dance hall music? Like, you know, in the contemporary era.
Well, that one is really cultural, as well as folk music is. But dance hall spreads its wings it further. It's a style of living. It's not a rhythm, because you have all kinds of music that's included in dancehall that has entirely different rhythms.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them are just ballads. Dancehall as a form of dress. It's outlandish.
Yes.
It's as a form of behavior and speech. Everything goes to the extreme.
That's for sure.
And the music also follows that pattern. Sometimes it goes beyond the extreme and we have to put it back. Mostly the rhythm of dancehall is a DJ rhythm, but it doesn't have to be just a DJ alone.
Well, I know you have a wide range of music on the Reggae Golden Jubilee selection, but I was interested that there is a good amount of dancehall represented, as well as ska and other forms of Jamaican.
Dancehall is the popular genre at the present time,
mm-hmm.
and it has been so since it goes right back to the 80s, 1980s, but mostly in the 90s it came alive, and it's still very popular. But some people feel that the standard is deteriorating, that there's no melody there. The words are sometimes obfuscated by the type of dialect language that is used.
Mm-hmm.
So you're left with a rhythm, and that's what dancehall really is, more than anything, it's a rhythm.
Yes. But there's a message as well. I mean, you have the song Poor People Fed Up by Bounty Killer on there.
That's in all parts of Jamaican music. You have songs that are message music.
Mm-hmm.
This is Rodney Price, a.k.a. Poor People Governor. When poor people fed up, to your system shake up, you issue gun fi whipping me balls. Poor people fed up, to your system shake up, when every day they get to use that door. Me ask the leader, him and the audience.
You know, we have 50 years of history to try to cover in a short time, and I wanted to take you back to one of the most famous moments in Jamaican music history, which was, of course, the peace concert. When Bob Marley invited you on stage to join hands with Mr. Manny. Was that planned? Was that something that had been organized ahead of time, or was it just a spontaneous?
Well, whether Bob planned it or not, I don't think we can even say. But it wasn't planned by myself or Manny. So Bob could have acted impromptu. Or you could have planned to do this before, we just don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Could we have up here, on stage here, the presence of Mr. Michael Mann and Mr. Edward Seaga? Oh!
Did you hear him asking on the microphone, or did someone? Okay.
Yeah.
And were you reluctant to join him on stage, or did you say, okay, let's just do it?
No, he said, I'd like Mr. Manley and Mr. Seaga to join me on stage.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I was sitting pretty close to the stage. So I moved forward to the front of the stage, and there were other people on the stage with him, and some of them were supporters of mine, and they leaned over and put me up.
Oh.
Manley, on the other hand, he went around the side of the stage to his step. So I got up there first, and he came up after.
It's an amazing image, that moment. It
was a very, very emotional moment. And you know, you saw people who were the day before enemies and fighting each other, sitting beside each other in the National Stadium.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, it never lasted for too long. It was there, the impact was there for a while, but it never lasted right throughout the rest of the campaign. That was in 1978.
Ah, yes, okay. And so there were some hard times to come after that.
Yes, because times got harder.
Yeah.
And things got rougher at the political level.
Yes.